Gage Primar here, crushbackpain.com. Today we're going to discuss herniated discs. Oftentimes people get really concerned after they find out they have a herniated disc on MRI. Today we're going to discuss how these discs actually heal over time. It's called reabsorption, and over 50% of the time, a herniated disc will reabsorb. And we're going to talk about how this is proven in the medical literature, and we're also going to discuss how even if the disc doesn't reabsorb, you can still be symptom-free. So that's what we're going to cover today. As always, let me know any questions you have, anything you want to know about lower back pain, ask it below, and I'll be sure to cover it here on the Crush Back Pain YouTube channel. A herniated disc is a common finding on MRI with or without lower back pain. So just as many people without lower back pain have herniated discs compared to people with lower back pain. This is important to remember. Another thing that most people don't realize is that herniated discs heal on their own most of the time. So the disc is a biological tissue just like muscle, bone, tendons, ligaments, and it heals on its own. And we know that we can actually get it to heal more effectively and heal stronger if we load it in specific ways. So healing of a herniated disc is referred to as reabsorption. And it's well documented in the medical literature. Herniated discs heal on their own 63 to 67% of the time. It depends on what literature you look at. There's obviously some variance. I've seen the reabsorption rate as high as 82% and as low as 40%. It just depends. But overall, the overall kind of consensus is somewhere between 63 and 67% of the time, a herniated disc will reabsorb on its own. It will heal. Really interesting, more severe herniated discs have the best chance of healing on their own. So there's different levels of a disc herniation. There's different stages. A prolapse, you can see this picture here. A prolapse is basically just a herniated disc or a bulging disc. And then an extrusion is where that inner disc material pushes out of what we call the annulus fibrosus, which is the outer part of the disc. And then a sequestration is where that inside of the disc, which we call the nucleus pulposus, actually separates from the disc and is completely outside of the disc. And these more severe herniated discs, the extrusions and the sequestrations, actually have a greater chance of reabsorption, and they have a greater chance of reabsorbing completely. So this is pretty incredible. Basically, your body will match its healing capacity to the severity of the disc herniation. So the rate of spontaneous regression was found to be 96% for disc sequestration. So that's the one, we'll go back to this picture, that's where the inside of the disc, the nucleus pulposus, actually separates completely from the disc and is free from the disc. So the sequestration has 96% chance for reabsorption. Now the disc extrusion, where the disc pushes out past the annulus but it's not separated, 70%. For a protrusion, which is essentially a bulge, 41%. Protrusion's more of a severe bulge. And then for disc bulging, where the inside of the disc doesn't actually push through any of the annulus, just the disc itself kind of bulges out, 13%. So the rate of complete resolution of disc herniation was 43% for sequestrated discs and 15% for extruded disc. Now this is complete resolution, where the disc completely heals 100%. The numbers above are for reabsorption, just not 100% reabsorption. A lot of times the reabsorption's over 50%, but it's not 100%. So you can see 100% reabsorption, you still have a chance for that with a sequestrated disc and an extruded disc. So as alluded to, your body literally matches its healing capacity to the severity of the disc herniation. This is incredible. Your body does what it needs to heal these more severe issues. And if the inside of the disc isn't actually pushed through the outside of the disc, then the reabsorption rate's not as great, just because it doesn't need to be, because there's not as great of a potential for there to be an issue with sciatica, back pain, leg pain.
So in people with sciatica due to a herniated disc, leg pain improves even if resorption does not occur. So, and this is a really interesting finding. So obviously, if you have sciatica due to a herniated disc, which disc herniation is the most common cause of sciatica, and the leg pain from sciatica is very, very common and affects a lot of people. So if you have sciatica due to a herniated disc, you can still be symptom-free even if the disc does not reabsorb. And this is just really telling. So you don't have to have sciatica symptoms with a herniated disc. And the majority of the time, the disc is going to reabsorb. And even if it doesn't, you can still be asymptomatic. I can't tell you how many people I see that think because they have a herniated disc, they're doomed to a life of sciatica symptoms and lower back pain. This just isn't the case. The medical literature is very clear that this isn't the case. So from a statistical standpoint, odds are your herniated disc will heal via reabsorption. You have better odds that it will heal compared to that it won't heal. You have better than a 50-50 chance that the disc will reabsorb. Even if it does not, your sciatica pain will get better. So whether or not the disc reabsorbs, your sciatica pain is still going to get better. And that's because the sciatica pain is often due to the disc material, the nucleus pulposus. The chemicals in that nucleus pulposus irritate the nerve root. And that's what causes the sciatica symptoms. You can still have the disc bulge, but if you don't have that disc material, the nucleus pulposus irritating the nerve root, you're going to be asymptomatic. This is important to understand. So herniated discs heal on their own most of the time. Even if they don't heal, sciatica symptoms get better. With proper loading, you can make the disc heal more efficiently and you can make it heal stronger and you can reduce the chances that you're going to have a disc herniation in the future. And that's really important to understand as well. Your disc has a really good chance of healing if we load it correctly, which is we load it with movement work, exercise work. We can make it heal faster. We can make it heal better. And then with the proper exercise program, we can reduce the incidence of future disc issues. We can't guarantee they're never going to happen, but we can make them less likely with the proper exercise program. If you have a herniated disc and you need help getting it to heal, go over to crushbackpaincom and check out some of the programs we have there. And if you want your herniated disc to heal and you want to build a strong, pain-free back, check out the Crush Back Pain Extension Program. The extension program is more specific to disc issues, herniated discs. Go over, check out these programs. These can be game changers if you have sciatica symptoms, lower back pain. Good chance that it's going to respond to the Crush Back Pain Extension Program. If you have any questions on lower back pain, make sure to let me know what those are and I'll cover them here on the Crush Back Pain YouTube channel. If this video helped you, if you liked it, leave a comment below, leave me a thumbs up, and check back every week for more information on how to build a strong pain-free back.